can use balloons to make fabric for countless variety of different sized sculptures. Inflate two balloons leaving about 8-inch flat tails. In this example, I use yellow and blue balloon to make a small size flag of Ukraine. Twist the first 1-inch yellow and blue bubble. Lock the free end of the yellow and the blue bubble together in one lock twist. Twist the second blue 2-inch bubble. Twist the third blue 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first three blue bubbles in one lock twist. Alright, we're going to twist all bubbles of the same 1-inch size, except where I mention different size. Twist the second yellow 2-inch bubble. Twist the third yellow 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first three yellow bubbles in one lock twist. Now we twist the fourth yellow and fourth blue bubble. Normally we use one or more balloons to make just one row of a fabric. However, in this instruction we will use each balloon to make two rows of a fabric. Lock the free end of the fourth yellow with the free end of the fourth blue bubble. Twist the chain of next two yellow and chain of the next two blue bubbles. I think it's important to use less possible number of balloons to make any sculpture. And this instruction is pretty much about it. Otherwise, we would make it with four balloons instead of two. Okay, lock the free end of the last yellow and the free end of the last blue bubble in one lock twist. Twist the seventh blue 2-inch bubble. Twist the eighth blue bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last three blue bubbles in one lock twist. That's a hard part. We have to pull the rest of the blue balloon through the loop between the fifth and sixth blue and yellow bubbles. Okay, now we twist a chain of the next two blue bubbles. We made a total of 10 blue bubbles, that's all we need. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 10 blue bubbles in one lock twist. Again, the hard part, we have to pull the rest of the blue balloon through the loop of bubbles. Now we have to work with the yellow balloon in the same fashion as we just did the blue balloon. Twist the seventh yellow 2-inch bubble. Twist the eighth yellow bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last three yellow bubbles in one lock twist. After that we twist the chain of the next two yellow bubbles. Then we lock both ends of the chain of first 10 yellow bubbles in one lock twist. There are many more one or two color flags that we can make using the same technique. Just choose proper colors. Maybe I will post some more pictures, examples of this small size flags on my blog. You'll find all links at fewdoit.com. Alright, let's finish with this flag. Cut off the rest of the blue balloon, tie off the end. Cut off the rest of the yellow balloon as well and tie off the end. You also may want to trim off the ends of the knots using scissors. I misplaced my scissors, so I will just leave the ends as it is. Congratulations, well done. We have made a flat sculpture, piece of fabric. It looks exactly the same from both sides. Now let's make another piece using three colors, three balloons. Inflate all balloons leaving about 7-inch flat tail. For this instruction I use Russian national flag colors, white, blue and red. We are going to use the same technique as previously. We will use each balloon to twist, wow, 18 bubbles. We twist all bubbles of the same up to 1-inch size, except when I mention different size. Twist the first white and the first blue bubbles. Lock the free end of the white bubble with the free end of the blue bubble. Twist the second white less than 2-inch bubble. Twist the third white bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first three white bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the second blue less than 2-inch bubble. Twist the first red bubble. Lock the free end of the first red bubble with the free end of the second blue bubble. Twist the third blue bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first three blue bubbles in one lock twist. Once again, we're going to use each balloon to make two rows of the fabric. Twist the second red less than 2-inch bubble. Twist the third red bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first three red bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the fourth white bubble. Twist the fourth blue bubble. Lock the free end of the white and the blue fourth bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next two white bubbles. Twist the chain of the next two blue bubbles. Lock the free end of the last blue and the last white bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next two white bubbles. Twist the chain of the next two blue bubbles. Lock the free end of the last white and the last blue bubbles in one lock twist. If you don't have enough balloon, you can end the row right now. I twist two more white bubbles. Twist the chain of the next two blue bubbles. Lock the free end of the last white and the last blue bubbles in one lock twist. So far we made total of 10 white bubbles, 10 blue bubbles. Let's catch up with the red balloon. Twist a chain of 7 red bubbles. So all together it would make 10 red bubbles as well. Okay, here's a chain of the 7 red bubbles. Twist the 11th red less than 2-inch bubble. Twist the 11th blue less than 2-inch bubble. Lock the free ends of the last blue and the last red bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 12th blue bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last three blue bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 12th red bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last three red bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the next blue and the next red bubble. Lock the free end of the last blue and the last red bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the next blue bubble. Now we just following the line. Lock the free end of the last blue bubble between the next two in a row blue bubbles. Twist the next red bubble. Lock the free end of the last red bubble between the, I think it's 7 and 8 red bubbles. with the next blue bubble, twist the next red bubble, lock the three ends of the last blue and the last red bubble in one lock twist, twist the next blue bubble, lock the free end of the last blue bubble between the fifth and the sixth blue bubbles. Twist the next red bubble. Lock the free end of the last red bubble between the fifth and the sixth red bubbles. Oops, that's not a problem, we'll fix it. Twist the next blue bubble, twist the next red bubble, lock the free ends of the last red and the last blue bubble in one lock twist. Twist the last 18th blue bubble, lock both ends of the chain of the first 18 blue bubbles in one lock twist. Okay, so the length of this piece of fabric is almost twice longer compared with the first piece of fabric we made. Now let's twist the last red 18th bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 18 red bubbles in one lock twist. Okay, let me stress your attention. I think it's very important to understand. We use 3 balloons to make 6 rows of fabric in this instruction. We can use as many more balloons as we want. Any color variations. Back to our sculpture. Twist the 11th white less than 2 inch bubble. Twist the 12th bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 3 white bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next 2 white bubbles. Lock the free end of the last white bubble between the 7 and the 8 white bubbles. Twist the next 2 white bubbles. Lock the free end of the last white bubble between the 5th and the 6th white bubbles. The fabric tends to roll in the same direction as we made the locks, or as we twist balloons. Twist the next 2 white bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 18 white bubbles in one lock twist. Alright, we made it. 6 rows of fabric, 2 rows of each color. The sculpture looks the same on both sides. I forgot, we have to cut off the rest of the balloons. We can use scissors to cut off the rest of the balloons, or do it with your hands, wherever you're comfortable. This piece of fabric is very flexible. Its structure allowed us to use it as a canvas, as a base for more complicated sculptures. We can use it as a flag. We can use it to build house or cake. The more you work with the fabric, the more use you will find for it. You can use the scissors to trim off the ends of the knot, or just hide it between bubbles. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. With so many bubbles, it would take forever, I guess. Congratulations, we have done it. We used white, blue and red to make the Russian flag. And we use blue and yellow to make flag of Ukraine. We can shape fabric to make different sculptures. We even can roll it in different ways. Make kind of a spiral. Use use it to make poles, spirals, and so on and so on. We can use sewing threads or pieces of flat balloons to tie the ends to fix the sculpture in proper position. I will make more examples and instructions of this use of fabric to make different kind of sculptures. Now I want to attach Ukraine flag to the pole. For this purpose I will use flat balloon. Let's attach the flat balloon along the short side of the flag. Simply force it between bubbles, wrap it. We will hide the flat balloon between bubbles of the flag. We have to leave about 2-3 inch long piece of flat balloon on each side of the flag. That's what we're going to use to attach the flag to a pole. Alright, that's good enough. That's how we're going to attach the flag. Inflate a brown balloon, leaving about 2 inch flat tail to make the pole. Twist the first 2 inch bubble. Twist the next 2 soft 1 inch bubbles. Lock all ends of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. That's a one point where we're going to attach the flag later. The next bubble we twist about the same size as the short side of the flag. We can use the flag to measure it. And twist the fourth bubble. Twist the next 2 soft 1 inch bubbles. Lock all ends of the last 2 brown bubbles in one lock twist. We will attach the bottom of the flag to this point. Okay, we have made the pole. Now we have to attach the top of the flag to the top of the pole. Just for the end of the flat balloon between bubbles of the pole on the top. In similar way we attach the bottom of the flag. Once we attach the flag, we can cut off the rest of the flat ends or just hide them between bubbles of the pole. We can use the pole to make a head. Use the bottom part of the pole to measure the size of the head and then twist it, leaving just 1 inch bubble at the end of the pole to keep the flag in fixed position. This way we can use it as a pole and as a head at the same time. Have fun and happy twisting!